something amazing happened today. No, it's not Google, with an homage to another mathematician as is their penchant. I can tell you this, that mathematicians have not added anything, really important to the world at all. Because after what happened to me today, I know this is true. What has added something really, what has been helpful to us in the world, is really the spiritual teachers. Now, I always say about the non-dual teachers, the Neo-Advaitins, all, you know, spiritual teachers, I just say, hey, let's do a little better. Come on, I want a little more, come on. But it's not that I disagree with them really entirely, no. I just want a little more juice, because it's important. We got to really, really do our very best at this time. But what I experienced today was really amazing. Really amazing. It's basically, wow, I realized that the person is a fiction. There is no person there. I realized the I is a fiction. There's no I there. The so-called self, there is no self there, really. I had this deep realization, and I realized that it's all the ego. The name, the person we think we are, is just the ego. And we're trying to please that person. We're working for a quote-unquote person, an I, a self. We're giving all our efforts to try and please this self, this person that we're supposed to be. There is no such person. It's the ego. The ego has endless names. Your name is another name for the ego. My name is another name for the ego. Everybody's name, the person that you're supposed to be, the idea that you're supposed to become someone, that's the ego. That is the ego. We've all been scammed and conned by the ego, as a matter of fact. And this hit me not conceptually at all. It hit me deep inside. And I just said, holy cow. I said, wait a minute. Something's not right. And so it was a deep kind of realization, actually. That's the kind that you want, and I want more, absolutely. So, you know, I think that there are teachers who have realized this to some extent, that there's just been this scam. We're being scammed entirely, actually. And they talk about it, yes, but it really needs to be deepened. I said, let's take a bulldozer and just bulldoze the entire thing, you know, off a cliff. This entire complex, egoic complex, is a complete lie. We are simply working to bolster the ego's agenda. We're not working for any self, any person. There are no persons, as I said. None of us have even ever been born. But we keep thinking that we need to live up to being this so-called person, which is just fictitious. It's entirely fictitious. And so this was some, you know, deep gut, deep, very depth seeing and realization of this today. And I was just, I was fine. I said, this is great. Bring it on. This is more. Come on. I love this. This is fantastic. Love seeing this. And, but the rest of the day went, you know, fairly smooth. But it probably has to do with some of this anxiety, a lot of terrible anxiety, because I'm starting to see that this has all been just a complete scam. Everything of us trying to work all our efforts and determination, etc. We think we're working for the person that we're told that we are. We're told that we're a person. Not true. Not true at all. Not true at all. The person that we are told is a fiction. And everybody else has this fiction going. They say, oh yeah, I'm a person. Yeah, you're a person. You're taught you're a person. And that your life is dedicated to this person. No. The life that we have been dedicating is been a dedication to the ego. And the ego is not a person. The ego is a training program, actually, designed to train us how to die to what we really are. And so we've really dedicated our life to just trying to die to what we are. And, you know, this realization was not as bad or shocking as I thought it would be. I enjoyed it. I said, this is great. I love this ride. And I feel, you know, just normal today. Now I just feel normal. But I hope that this realization returns in greater depth and intensity for sure, because it wasn't bad at all. It wasn't bad at all. You hear about, like, Muji's story about Punjaji, you know, busted his ego, and Muji went out and is furious, you know, and he walked down around and just so completely upset, and then he suddenly, dropped it. Yeah, well, you know, it wasn't anything that intense, really. But even if it was, that would be fine. I mean, it was enjoyable. I said, hey, this is great. This is great. I love seeing this. But at the same time, there's like a wow. This is like such a, I've been duped, really severely duped. But all along, we've known we've been duped. But somehow, something registered. So, those who have been teaching, yes, that the I, the person, is a fiction, their teaching is accurate. It's accurate as far as it goes, okay? As far as, there's greater depth to the situation, actually. But that, as far as it goes, is very, very true. And all our determination and perseverance and all these qualities we've been using, all these qualities we've been trying to use, you know, to elevate this person. You know, there is no person. The ego has just been duping us. And it's, you can't explain it conceptually. You have to somehow get a glimpse of it in a deeper sense. And that's what happened. You can hear it a thousand times and not get it. But what it was I just saying, what if I had this dream of this beautiful estate? I was born in poverty, and you dream you have a beautiful estate someday, and you spend every moment of your life working as hard as you can, sacrificing as much as possible, using tremendous qualities of perseverance and clarity and effort, etc., working yourself to the bone, and you finally one day you have this incredibly beautiful estate, you know, and somebody comes along and they say, hey, nice place you got here. Boy, you're really lucky, really fortunate person, you know. Super lucky to have a place like this. And inside I said, what are you talking about? You know. And I said, there's something wrong. This person wants to what? Take it away, take it from me. Saying that it was luck. I mean, that what is that? And how come we don't relate to one another when you see somebody with a really great situation? Why do you say, hey, wow, I really admire the characteristics that you must have used to fashion such a situation for yourself, man. I mean, you must have taken enormous, you know, effort and great qualities, you know, that kind of thing. Instead, we say, oh, wow, you're so lucky, you know, to have this. You're so lucky. There's something that struck me about that, that there's something very much wrong with the way we relate to one another, very much wrong. And then suddenly it started deepening and deepening and deepening. And that's when I began to see that there's something very wrong, very much wrong with the whole situation in the world. And so it something triggered it. There's it was triggered by my irritation towards people, the way that people act towards you. You know, they're trying to con you in some way when they say, oh, aren't you fortunate? Aren't you lucky? Yeah, that kind of thing. And so you never know what's going to you know, trigger something, but that's what happened. And the rest of it was kind of deeper than can be quite explained. If I tried to explain it conceptually, I would lose the depth of it. Because it the ramifications of it are huge, actually. So don't give up on digging in your spiritual path. Keep digging into it. Whatever path you're taking, keep digging into it, because something it will trigger. Actually, what I was desperate before this, actually, and I had been saying, today I have to get some asset for myself. I don't have anything. I can't survive. I'm having a nervous breakdown. I'm a future. I cannot navigate the future. It's not possible. And so I said, today I have to get something. I was really the most desperate I've ever been. And then, so just like an hour after that, suddenly I had this breakthrough and accepted that it was a level of acceptance. So it was sort of like a part of an enlightenment type of a recognition sort of situation, actually. But I have to go further now. I have to go further. But sort of letting myself adjust to this, really, this adjustment, because it hit hard. We've just been used. Our lives are just getting, we're just be getting used, absolutely, by this person that doesn't exist. We're all just pretending. I mean, it's just the colossal. I mean, the realization is just colossal. And no doubt there are those who have realized this. That's not the end of realization. Again, I think there's a lot more to the situation, but it's certainly a big step forward, actually. So, we have to have assets going forward. I'm telling you for sure. And so I've been pushing like crazy to get some assets, really, some genuine assets that we need. One of those assets is we're not a person. There are no people, no persons, no personas whatsoever. It's all a lie. It's like we've been in service to nothing. And I found my overall state of mind, psyche, was able to handle this recognition. And actually say, hey, love it. I love it more. You know, it could just able to digest it and say, you know, eat the food, digest it. So it wasn't a problem. But I could see how it might be a problem if you're not ready for it. Because you might feel disconsolate, actually. Very just devastated by it. So the preparation is very important. Preparation is super important. That's why all the teachers say you have to spend a life to make it your career. Make it your career, because you have to get to a point where it doesn't strike you too hard. Otherwise, you're not going to be able to handle it. That's why those who try to force it in some way, like with drugs or something, that's stupid. That's stupid. You're going to actually cause a complex. You have a backlash and a really strong walled-off complex. And it's going to make it actually delays, in my opinion. So you just have to keep working at it. And just, again, pull the fabric apart. You know, the situation now is so intense, I'm telling you. That's why I'm just pulling it all apart here on the videos. Pulling it all apart. Gotta do it. Nothing is sacred right now. There are no sacred cows right now, okay? No sacred cows. Open up the whole thing. Whatever we can, just, you know. We can't say, oh, we can't say something about this or something about that. No, we can say something about everything. Whatever we can say right now, say it. You know, whatever we can say to say no sacred cows. There are no sacred cows right now. We only are looking for the truth of the situation. We're looking for the truth. And I've said in previous videos recently, the better you see your options, the better off you are. Even if one of those options is terrible. And we don't want to soft pedal the options at this point. This is why I'm being very adamant about this right now. You're either going to get enlightened or you're going to end up trying to learn to love death. That is a fact. I've seen that absolutely clearly, and I'm adamant about that. Is people in this world, most people here, are getting very severely into a love of death syndrome, necrophiliac syndrome, very severely, and it's uncommented upon, you know, and it's true. It's absolutely true what's going on in this world. These are the times that was spoken about in the Bible of the weed from the tares. What's a tare? It's a noxious weed, actually. and there's going to be a separation of the sheep and the goats. And what are the goats? They're the ones that eat the noxious weeds, actually. And the noxious weed is the love of trying to learn to love death, which is this training program that Spirit has asked mind to devise for. See, Spirit asked mind to devise this program. It's not mind's fault. But when you ask mind to do something, it's going to go all in. It's going to go all in. It's not holding anything back. Mind is all in on this. So we have to be all in with the Holy Spirit, with the clarity, with the voice of reason, with that area in our mind which is aware and clear of what's going on. Because we have a choice. We can either go with the goats or we can go with the sheep. We can either go with the program of trying to really learn how to love death, or we can drop that program and for the perfect no, saying no, we can never truly love death. It's impossible. We cannot die. It's impossible. And when we take that route, then we will see that this whole person thing is really a corpse. The person is just a corpse, actually. And we're trying to, you know, bring this corpse to life. But in trying to do so, we ourselves feel like we're dying. Okay? The person, what people call us, your name, hey, you know, so they're talking to dead flesh. It's not even dead. It's just simply not alive. It's not alive. The flesh is not alive. It's not life. And we, as Spirit, are trying to breathe life into flesh, and that's impossible. And the effort to do so exhausts us. It wipes us out. We feel so, you know, dead ourselves, as it were. We sort of get this feeling like, wow, I just feel so completely burned out and conflicted in this. And that is how we try to train ourselves how to die. We train ourselves how to die by identifying with flesh and then trying to bring the flesh to life. And it makes us feel so tired, and the flesh, you know, gets burned out from that, of course. You know, it doesn't function so well. And that's the trick that's happened to us. We need to just stop trying to bring the flesh to life, because there isn't any life there. There's never been any life there, never will be any life there. It's just a formation of dust. And so, of course, for all those who are subtly cheerleading on this effort, you know, you have those that has to be brought out in the open. We cannot do it. And the effort to do it is now at this point wiping us out. Because what happens is the ego will again put you in a catch-22 situation. And it'll burn you out, so to speak. You know, burnouts is I'm experiencing a severe burnout at this point in time. So much severe pressure is coming upon the world right now. If you don't want to do this, the ego insists, well, just do both. Learn to die and recognize that you can't die. Do both. That pressure is on us, and that causes us to feel very severe stress. So we have to, again, just put it all on the line, like the mind is, again, putting it all on the line right now, trying to keep us engrossed in this insane effort. We don't need the body at all to experience who we are. We can't experience who we are through the body. It's impossible. We don't have to have the body do anything to be what we are. We don't have to elevate the body to be who we are. We don't have to kill the body to be who we are. We don't have to do anything at all with the body to be what we already are. The flesh is really nothing, nothing at all. Will always be nothing. And this the ego calling the flesh a name, and then saying the flesh is what you are, and you haven't realized yourself until you've fully, you know, enlighten the flesh, as it were. That is the insanity. That is insanity. Effort we put in it, all this effort that we have put in, is to no avail. It was a complete waste of time. Utter waste of time. And how you relate to that, it's a difference between, you know, enlightenment and getting caught in a catch-22. I seem to be relating to it pretty well. So I'm emboldened by that, saying, hey, you know, I think I can take more. I think I can take more disillusionment. Absolutely, bring it on. Bring it on. Bring the bulldozers on. Bulldoze the whole thing right now. You know, when bliss comes along, I'm going to say, hey, infect me with bliss right now. I hope you're completely infectious, and I'm going to get right there so I get, you know, completely infected. So this is the time when controversial things will be said. This is the time where they have to be said. If you don't say it now, it's going to be too late. Really, it is going to be too late. So I'm just, you know, just bringing everything up, controversial or not, and putting it up there so people just, you know, they'll feel like, hey, you know what, a breakthrough's possible. Somehow it might help out, so help somehow in some way, feeling like, you know what, maybe I can stand the disillusionment. Maybe I can stand it. And I need to really, really keep trying, keep trying, keep trying, every day keep trying. Gotta make it now. We need the assets going forward. We need to be to disassociate with the flesh, this whole scheme of the ego, this scheme to teach ourselves how to die. We need to disassociate from it. Absolutely need to disassociate from it. That's why in the dream I told the guru, I said, guru, we gotta take a walk, meaning let's disassociate from it. We have to disassociate from it. That's what it really means. Now, it could be a literal walk also. It could be actual spatial disassociation with what's going on in the world, the necrophilia, the NPC, necrophiliac channel, which is the Earth. If Earth was a television channel, it would be the NPC, not necrophiliac channel. They would probably have something like GNPC, Global Necrophiliac Channel. You are now watching GNBC. Good evening, everyone. Then they'll trot some idiot comedian on there or something, right? GNPC. Yeah. So this planet, if it's a channel, you would say for sure it's the Global Necrophiliac Channel, lovers of death. So this is sickening. The whole thing is sickening, actually. We're getting sick from it. It's sickening. You can't help it. It's sickening. Now, the true saviors have completely dissociated from this. And so they're helpful. So it doesn't sicken them. But we're not there yet. So it is really sickening us, actually. It seems like what's happening with my life right now is getting ready for this disassociation for sure, and just be able to handle this today, this you know, this realization today was colossal realization. Actually, I was able to handle it quite well. Be able to just accept it, not only accept it but embrace it and say, this is great. I love this. So that shows that there is this dissociation process taking place here. And then I'm passing that on to any and everyone who wants to watch it. Realizing not everything I say, not everybody's going to like everything that's said, because we're just bringing everything up, we're shining a light everywhere. And maybe, you know, some people say, wow, it's too much light, too much light, too much light, too fast. Well, it's got to be fast right now. There's got to be fast right now. The sickness of the world is worse. One of the themes of these videos is it's worse than you realize, than we realize. It's worse, and it's happening faster than we realize. That's one of the core themes. It's happening faster than we realize, and it is worse than we realize. So you have to push, 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 push. And don't just count on the ego to tell you how fast you should go. The ego's a liar and a deceiver, okay? And it wants to to kill you, basically, all right? He wants to teach you how to kill yourself. The ego does, absolutely. So don't trust the ego in telling you, ah, yeah, some problems, you know, yeah. No, it's the world is very, very sick right now. Very sick. And very contagious of this bad sickness. And, you know, it's getting into us. It's getting into us. So we need to catch another different type of contagion, for sure. Contagion of truth. Contagion of bliss. We need to be in get a severe case of bliss. So it is worse than we realize, and the time is shorter than we realize right now. The overall subtle vibe of the world is this enormous tolerance for the darkness trying to learn to love death. There's an enormous tolerance for this in the world right now. Whereas before there was not. There's a great intolerance of it, actually. It's flip-flopped because of a very determined campaign from many angles, actually. And a soft selling of the whole situation, a huge soft sell on the whole situation. And after this realization, I had some experiences, actually, which were quite, there were some severe attempts to distract me, I'm telling you, very severe attempts. And I didn't appreciate them. I did not appreciate them at all. You know, the ego plays dirty. Really does. Hits you below the belt. It's very, very terrible what's taking place in the world. There is, you know, as the ego tries to engross us in death, and it tries to make it seem like we're heading towards some kind of paradise, some utopia, actually. And how does it do that? Well, there's you know, the usual, try out the usual suspects. You know, turn the world into Sodom and Gomorrah, as it were. Turn the world into a hedonistic paradise, as it were. And you know what happened today was just like, I said, oh, come on, you know, it's just really, really. I mean, it was just pathetic. It was pathetic, but it's the sign of the times. I'll tell you something, that the average woman of today is more of a prostitute than the prostitutes of the past. They're more shameless, they're more aggressive, they're more bold, etc., than the prostitutes of the past. Just the average, everyday high school girl is, actually. And that's what happened today. There's a group of high school kids, of male and female, and they were just filthy, you know, absolutely filthy and disgusting. And in public, just, you know, venting their degeneracy and stuff, you know. It was just like, and I just said, you know, I don't want to hear that. You know, just, you know, get that out of my space. Don't want that. But that is a fact, that the planet, you know, the whole planet, is the females have been taught to be very, very aggressive and bold and perverted and degenerate, actually, like prostitutes. And then the men are laughing, saying, oh, isn't this great? Isn't it wonderful? What a great world there is. You know, look how the women are now. You know, they think, hey, this is Candyland. You know, no, it's going to be Deathland, actually. That's how death disguises itself. Okay. That's how death disguises itself. It's a dead giveaway, you know, very much dead giveaway. And, you know, it's just, it's really unwelcome kind of stuff. And is it really, you know, the ego is trotting out, you know, it's doing all its tricks, as it were. And again, the kids today have just been so completely saturated and indoctrinated with this incredibly sleazy culture, okay. And for them, they just think like, oh, this is funny. This is funny. This is fun. Funny. Yeah. Hey, it's a cover-up. It's a cover-up for what's really happening. It's easy to get your head turned and say, wow, you know, what's going on? You know, this, it's party time. You know, the whole world's going to be a big party central. No, it's not. It's going to be death central. It's hiding the fact that this whole world is going toward a necrophiliac situation. GCPN, Global Necrophiliac Network, is this globe right now. And basically what the ego is trying to tell me. It says, hey, how can you possibly leave this planet? Look, I mean, you got a whole planet full of prostitutes, you know. Well, what a party you're going to have. You know, and I just say that, what, pathetic, absolutely pathetic. Revolting and pathetic, actually. And so the ego hit me with all this stuff. I said, wow, you know, the ego's really, really pissed off that I, you know, saw this. It's trying to say, oh, how can you possibly leave? It's going to be really fun here. I said, no, it's going to be really dead here. That's a good reason to disassociate from the entire thing. Isn't it very good to disassociate? All right, let's get this up on YouTube. Because, again, we are pushing the envelope here all out, full throttle. Full throttle. That's it.